Today we're going to talk about a few things to make your pop time faster, the throw from catcher down to second base, because this is very important when it comes to keeping guys out of scoring position. If you have a quick pop time, you're going to be a more successful team, a more successful catcher. And today we've got Will Nieves, 12-season Major League veteran.
Line to left field, that's got a lot of carry.
Toward right center field, that's pretty well hit. Hayward on the run, he's not going to get there. It's going to go over the wall in one hop. A ground rule double for Nieves.
Here's the pitch. He swings, drills one to right field. It's a bases clearing double for Will Nieves.
He's going to tell us a few tips on how to have a faster pop time.
Thank you, Young. Beat it.
Wait, you guys don't want to see catching videos from me anymore? Would you rather see me do catching videos or Will?
Thank you. Thank you, Jan. Thank you. So a couple of things that we're going to talk about, you know, throwing the ball to second. It's going to be important for you guys to get it right. You know, I've seen a lot of guys with unbelievable arms and with a bad mechanic, and they cannot throw anybody out. And I see vice versa. I see guys that they don't have that strong of an arm, but their mechanics are so good that they always, you know, get a good pop time to second base. They always throw that ball, you know, right there. Give your teammates a chance to, you know, to make the tag. So most important thing, guys, is just you know, you wanna be comfortable. We're men of first base, right? You wanna stagger your feet. You wanna stagger your feet a little bit. The way I did it, when I was nobody on base, if I trace a line, I will be right on top of that line, both feet. So I'm giving a nice target to my pitcher, right in the middle, square. Somebody on base, I keep top of the line, this one. And this one, I just cheat a little bit. I don't do it as much. If you see me, I'm still giving my target in the middle, my body still straight, facing that way. I'm not sideways, I'm not like this. I've seen guys like that, you know, because they're running first, they're trying to be faster, you know, throwing the ball to second. But what happened? If I'm sideways, I'm not giving my pitcher a good target so he can hit. You know, most important thing is you give a good target. Most important thing right now, guys, is the guy hitting. This is the guy we're trying to get out. We don't know if he's gonna steal the base. So the most important thing is I'm gonna give a good target to my pitcher so he can hit it. So now, I'm a little bit, I stagger my feet a little bit. Now I'm in a good angle. All right, guys, so a lot of you guys have been taught, you know, put this hand behind that glove. So I don't like it. I don't want you to do it because you can break a finger. Why is that? If I'm giving my target with my hand there, if the pitch is not right in the middle, you gotta go get it, guys. You're gonna go get the pitch. What's gonna happen with this hand? It's gonna stay right there. I'm pretty sure you're not gonna be, if the pitch is that way, you're gonna go like this. This hand will not follow the glove, will not, be right? Because it feels uncomfortable. So if you're here, pitch down, fingers there, foul tip, you're done, all right? You're done. So the way they taught me, that I learned, it was, first of all, assume that I give my sign, guys, give my sign. I'm protecting that thumb. Nobody on base, like you guys know, you put it back here. Somebody on base, I want you to put it right here, guys. Right here. No, I don't have my elbow like this. I'm just resting my hand there. Look, it is really hard if the ball hit you there. Foul tip, you have this, you have the glove, you have your chest protector. If I have my chest protector, I will have more coverage for the arm. Now, when we're getting ready, we want that ball to travel. We don't want to go get it. Why? If you go get that ball, now your first step is going to be so long. You're going to be stepping at home plate. You're going to slide, and it's going to be long. That big step is going to give that guy an extra couple more steps to get to second, and that could be the difference of you throwing him out or him being safe. So you want that ball to travel. I guarantee, guys, you're gonna be faster just let that ball travel and just wait for it. So now you can be short and you can be effective and you can be compact throwing to second base. Now, when the ball is coming, guys, and I catch it, three steps that I really want you to get this. Three steps to throw to second. Catch it. Most important thing, you're gonna catch it, get it out, footwork. Catch it, get it out, footwork. Some guys wanna catch it, do footwork, and they get it out. You're not gonna have a good grip. Guys, catch it, get it out, footwork. That's how it works. A lot of times they catch it, footwork, now they get it out. My body's ready to throw. I don't have a good grip. I'm throwing it away. First move that I do, guys, I'm turning this knee a little bit in. I'm not moving my feet. I'm turning it in. Now this one goes to my base. This one's gonna go to my base. Where's my base? Right here. I'm not going back. I'm not going this way that I see a lot of guys doing that. A lot of guys are here. They go this way. So their momentum is going this way to throw to second. So you're losing momentum. Now all your energy is coming this way when we're trying to throw to the ball second. So you're not gonna throw the ball, you know, hard, and you're not using your body, you know, to throw it faster to second base. So guys, when I work on my mechanic, right, to throw to second, I like to work on a tee. This you can do here, you can do with a bat like I'm gonna do now, or you can do it in your garage. You can put a piece of tape, white tape, you can put it on the floor, on the ground, a tee. So we're gonna do a tee. Again, I'm doing it here. You can do it in your garage, so no excuses. You can do this at home. So now look, I'm gonna work in a tee. I'm gonna be in top of this line. I'm gonna be in top of this line, right? Now, when I get the pitch and I turn, this foot goes, I'm gaining a little bit of momentum. Not a lot, just a little bit of momentum going forward, and I'm staying on that tee. You see? So I told the guys, get him up, get him down. My feet, get him up, get him down. So if you're too long, now you're gonna be too long, you're gonna either step on the play or you're gonna go past. And that's why a lot of guys get in trouble, now you're too long. You wanna be short, guys. Catchers, it is a tough throw, but if you make it simple and you do it continuously, you know, the right way and the same way, you're gonna be good at it. It is tough because, you know, we don't have time to get that grip. So we wanna do the mechanic right, so we have a better chance. I told my kids, imagine that there's a rope right here and you wanna stay under that. A lot of guys, they catch it, the first thing they do, they come up. Now all they have is arm, they're not using the legs. Catchers, we're athletic. They used to be, back in the day, if you were fat, unathletic, you were tall, you know, you couldn't play any other position, hey, go catch. No, now. Now you have guys that they're really athletic back there. Okay, guys, so I want you to think, when you catch the ball, I don't want you to go down. I don't want that glove to go down this way, because what's gonna happen? Now the exchange is gonna happen down here. Your arm is gonna be so long, right? You're gonna be long. Your body's ready to throw. Now you're trying to catch up, and you're just gonna let the ball go anywhere. You can let it go here, just whatever. Same with pitching. Pitching, if the guy, they don't break the hands quick enough, they're trying to catch up, they're not gonna have a consistency release point. Catchers, that happens the same thing. If we're too long, we're not gonna have that release point consistently, so we can throw it to second base. So what's gonna happen with a glove? What's gonna happen with a glove? Once we catch it, it doesn't matter where I catch it, my glove's gonna go, it's gonna go straight to this shoulder. Why? Obviously because my hand is there. I'm not gonna flip it. I really wanna get my glove to go all the way here. First of all, because I want the exchange to be there. Second of all, look how my shoulder now is closed. If I don't do that, I can stay open easily. But if I'm here and I go all the way here and I bring my glove to this shoulder, look that elbow. Now I'm ready to throw the second. You know, I'm not open because I didn't do the exchange here. I'm closed because I did it here. Now by the time I go like this, I'm getting a good grip. Now I go. Another thing that I want to tell you guys about throwing to second, it is second base is far. It is really far. And and it can be hard to throw it there. So I have a big key that I can tell you to make your throw a little bit easier, a little bit better. The way I did it, I pick a closer point. So if the pitcher was throwing, I aim for his head. Why? Because I knew if I hit him on his head, my ball was gonna go all the way to second. Again, if you pick a closer target and you throw it through that target, it's gonna get there. Some of you guys who have a good arm can aim a little bit lower with the pitcher. Weaker arm, you can see the head of the pitcher, couple feet higher, throw it through there. So pick an imaginary closer spot, closer target, that if you can throw it through there, it's gonna get to second. Again, second is a long way. It's a long way. If you pick a closer target, I guarantee you, you're gonna be more consistent and you're gonna be able to hit that second base better and more times than not.
Those are some great, great tips. One question for you. What is the difference in the stance, if any, with runners on versus runners off? I know you talked about being staggered and cheating a little bit, but what about like height? Because I see a lot of young guys when there's a runner on, they're like way up here versus when their regular stance is a lot lower. Is there any significance to that, or how would you explain that?
Well, you know what? Nobody on base, you want to be comfortable. You know, you want to be comfortable. So if you have your butt down, you know, that's good. Just be comfortable. What guys have to be careful with is, and coaches are gonna pick this, and smart runners are gonna pick this really easy. There's a lot of catchers that when they call breaking ball, their butt goes up. So as a runner, once I see the catcher with his butt up, now I know it's a breaking ball, so I'm taking off. Even if I didn't see the sign, I see the catcher a little bit higher. So now in my mind, I'm like, okay, this is a breaking ball. If I'm at second base and I see that, I can give a sign to the hitter, hey, breaking ball. So it happens. So as a catcher, I wanna be paying attention to that. Like, nobody on base, you wanna be comfortable, but perfect. You call breaking ball. As a catcher, I'm expecting that it's gonna bounce 100% of the time. I'm always gonna expect, every time I call a breaking ball, it's gonna bounce. I never expect that it was gonna be a strike, so I was ready to block it. I wasn't gonna pick it, I was ready, 100%. That 1% when I say I need it for a strike and he bounced it, I didn't block it and it went through and I looked horrible. So nobody on base, again, you can be comfortable right here, you can be lined up, you know, your feet, you know, the same, and nice target. Even breaking ball, with breaking ball, now you can go up, whop, and block it. Now, when I talk about being up with your butt, it's man on base. Do it with the fastball, do it with the breaking ball. You call fastball, you want your butt, look, you're here, nobody on base, right here. Somebody on base, just a little bit high. You're right, I've seen guys like this. Now, what happened? I'm giving my pitcher a higher target. Pitcher is gonna aim for that, we're gonna get hurt. Now they're gonna be throwing breaking balls up, fastball up, no. I wanna give a low target, still low target. My butt is a little bit higher, but not as much. Right there, I can go flop and do my mechanic. So it is just a little bit, John, just a little bit of that change of nobody on base, that butt is down, somebody on base, I'm a little bit higher.
That's awesome, Will. The footwork and the hands, you know, I think plays a crucial part because, you know, a lot of guys want to work on increasing their arm speed and getting their arm stronger to throw, and that's important. That can help a little bit, but the ball is always going to be moving faster out of your hand. So the quicker you can get it out of your hand, the quicker your pop time is going to be. But that does play a role in, you know, how quick your pop time is. So what are some things that you do to work on getting a faster arm and being able to throw the ball faster to second base?
You know what, like you say, beside mechanics, right? Beside fixing my mechanic and just being short and giving myself a chance to just be consistent. You know, I did a lot of arm work, you know, the arm bands. I did a lot of those and I play long toss. I did it every other day. that seems like getting my arm strong. Whenever I didn't play long toss, second base for me felt like it was a center field. It was that difference, that when I played long toss and I threw almost every day, I felt like second base like was like right there where the pitcher is. So for me, throwing long toss, and working on my throwing to the bases, because it's not the same playing long toss than literally throwing to the bases. Do it twice, three times a week. You know, throw to the bases. I tell kids, and I tell young people, you know what? When you're catching in the game, first of all, you did all your job, you know, practice and your free time at home. Hopefully you work extra. But I tell kids, the only chance that you have to make a good throw to seconds is in between innings. And I see a lot of kids, you know, they catch the ball and they go through the motion, and hey, that's your only practice shot to throw the ball to second. So take advantage of that. Really get down there and get that last pitch, whoop, and work on your game speed and making a nice throw there. So if in that inning you have an opportunity to throw the guy out, you already practice it and you already know how you feel that day. Because not every day you're gonna feel the same. So, but I think just creating a good habit of playing long toss and throwing to the bases at least twice a week, that's gonna be huge, because it's gonna make you feel that second base way closer than if you don't do those extra work.
That's awesome, Will. Some really great tips. And the biggest thing I want you guys to take away from this is not just coming here and watching the videos and listen what this MLB veteran has for you, but the reason why he got there and he did so well, one of the biggest reasons is because of the hard work. So when he says go out there and throw to the bases 2 to 3 times a week and get the long toss in, you know, you just coming here and watching the video and then sitting on your butt all week is not gonna help you get any better. It's not gonna increase your pop time, get you any faster with your pop time. You gotta be out there working. You gotta be putting in the work. And that's why I like to have guys like Will on here to share his experience with you guys. But if you don't do anything with it, it's not valuable, okay? So you have to put in the work and make it happen, okay? Guys, if you want to check out Will, he's on Facebook and Instagram, Will Nieves Academy. I'll leave a link below where you can find that stuff. Also, if you guys are in the Orlando area and want to do some private training with Will on catching or hitting, his email is down below in the description. You can hit him up there and he'd be happy to talk with you there. If you guys have any questions about how to increase your pop time or anything catching or hitting related, leave them down below in the comment section and Will and I will get down there and answer some of your questions. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button so you'll be notified anytime we upload some new videos. And I hope you like this one, guys. We'll see you in a new video very soon.